Good morning. Dan, did you just fart?
Yeah. Couple
of times. We did have a quarry last night, to be fair. Right, we're going. Got doctor's appointment in 7 minutes. So we need to set off, Danny.
Yep.
Is it raining?
It was two minutes ago and it stopped.
Gross.
It's going to start again in the next minute.
Okay.
I
have my Christmas present boots on. And they're so cute. I'm really glad I got them. They're totally not something I would normally wear, but they're proper, like, cozy boots with fluff and stuff. Over the moon with those, but we really need to go and get my baby checked. This t-shirt, it used to be baggy on me, and now it's like, look at that. Wow.
Oh, what are you doing?
So gross. Yeah. We're proper adulting, aren't we? Rose is buying adult things.
Sad day.
I am not.
You are a child. What's doing
that? What for?
What for?
Off the hob.
Candles.
For candles? Why didn't you buy one of these? Look.
You know, we've got, like, big candles.
Look, that's £1.50 for
Is it refillable?
Ones.
Is it refillable? Why did you buy two of it? It's refillable.
Why the hell not?
You know, we've got big candles.
Ooh, yeah.
And you?
You've got us, yeah. I do that thing where you light a piece of spaghetti.
I like life hacks.
Have you shown
that Dan stole his coffee from Morrison's cafe?
I finished.
Right, okay.
We actually got up to leave because there was a little old lady loitering around, looking very lost and like she needed a table to sit on. So we got up and then she sat down with somebody else anyway.
Did
she? Yeah, she sat down with that couple sharing fish and chips.
I don't think they really wanted to sit there.
Oh.
Doing.
Do we need anything else?
No.
Got coffee, got milk. We got something for tea.
I bought more milk.
Yeah, I know you did.
You've got food anyway, so.
Yeah. Do we need anything else? We've got salt, moon, and crisps. We'll be fine. What are you laughing at?
I just thought it said fresh dicks. It doesn't, it says dicks.
Are you disappointed? Ooh, plugins. Have they got a Christmas one? No.
I was looking at Shake and Vac, but we've only got Lily of the
Shake
Valley.
Oh, Shake and Vac's crap.
We've only got Lily of the Valley flavour.
Ben's always looking at cat stuff. You buy a candle every time we go out.
Well.
Yeah, I think so.
You've got your bullet, your tankers, all your prizes, the camera, you can keep that.
Yeah, keep the camera. Get everything. Aww. Hello. Hello. I feel like I'm really zoomed in. Oh, there we go. Hello. You come to watch Bullseye with us.
My wife and I are well into our fifth decade together. We still make love at least once. Usually twice, I thought I was going to say a week, a day.
What?
Occasionally more than that.
Fucking hell.
For me, nothing else in life comes anywhere close to the complete euphoria it brings. Now we're older, sex takes longer.
Mm-mm.
That's a bonus.
Oh.
We must have made love at least 22,000 times.
What?
1 to 2 times a day? Sometimes more. And you've been together... like,
when do they work, man?
Decades.
When do they go to work?
I know.
They must have really boring, lazy jobs where they don't do much.
Yeah. Been plenty of scope for variety. I've experimented with all sorts of positions. All with locations outside the bedroom, including a corner of our garden.
Oh.
One memorable highlight was 6 sessions in a private swimming pool. We managed to sustain uninterrupted coitus for 2 hours at a time over a couple of exhilarating days.
Right.
We've repeated that on several occasions.
Sorry, why is you writing in with this?
I don't know.
Has he got a question or?
I think he's just gloating about it. I think it's just like each week a reader tells us about their sex life. That's basically it. It's a Guardian, so someone can just email in with information about their sex life. And this is basically this guy writing in to gloat that, yeah, he has sex at least once or two times a day.
Well,
there we go.
That's just made my day.
Now I kind of want to go and see what the other one's been like.
I'll have myself a nice bath if you want to go.
Yeah, that sounds nice. Is something not many of you will experience.
What's
getting a hair tweezed out in between your teeth.
There you go.
You got it. Can you see it? Yeah, look. How gross is that? There, look. On the edge of my thumb. A hair. Delicious. Well, it makes change from it being in your foot, Dan.
Yeah, it does actually.
I'm getting ready. Check me out. I'm putting on makeup. Which I think I've only done once this week, maybe twice. It's quite liberating, I have to admit, having these eyelash extensions, because you really don't give a shit about the way you look. You could just wake up and, like, feel like Beyonce. And, of course, I don't know a single woman that wouldn't want that in their lives. I've been telling myself for about 2 weeks I need to clean my makeup brushes. I bet it's longer, to be honest. They're disgusting. Like, I've had to stop using some of them because they are so bad. That's definitely going to be tomorrow's job. Every time I put my makeup on, I'm sitting here going, right, tomorrow you're going to do it, Suze. And it's been 2 weeks now. Terrible. I'm getting ready for a gig. It's a Christmas party for a choir. And it's actually my friend Gemma's choir. Gemma, who I went to Spain with. Yeah, do you remember Suze before she was pregnant? My God. I don't think I've ever drank so much alcohol in my life. There's this challenge going around on Facebook that my friend Hugh, who also has a YouTube channel and presents a podcast, 37 Disney Street. I've probably mentioned it before. If you haven't, find it. It's really, really good. 37 Disney Street. He tagged me to take part in this challenge where you... What's it called? The Performer Artist Challenge. And for 10 days, you've got to upload a picture of yourself performing or doing your artist thing. And I thought, oh, shit. I mean, I'd love to do it, but I don't think I've been in 10 musicals. Turns out I have. Because I had more than 10 photographs when I actually went through them. This brush is knackered. When I actually went through all my Facebook photos of all the different shows I've done. There's way more than 10, so I was a bit gobsmacked at that. But yeah, it's really nice. And obviously, I have a lot of friends on Facebook that have done musicals and have done these, you know, done musicals with me. And I've seen them in stuff that I've not been in and that. And it's just so nice seeing everybody's photos. And it just makes me think, because a lot of people have said to me, oh, you're not going to be able to do your shows anymore when you've had a baby. Yeah, I know. That is okay. I think, you know, I've done quite a lot of musicals, actually. Ones that I've really loved, ones that I haven't. Ones that I would, you know, never do again. But then, It's going to be another adventure, isn't it? Having a baby and all that change that comes with it. And I can't wait. I can't wait for a change. I'm sick of people asking me, what are you doing next? What are you doing next? I don't know. I'm really excited to be a mummy. God, that's fucking weird saying that. Why do you make such a disgusting face when you're doing your eyeshadow? Oh, it's tragic. Yeah, nothing really eventful happened at the doctor's, to be honest. The midwife, I should say. She said, oh, have you got a pee sample to give me? I was like, no. You didn't give me a bottle, so do you want me to do one now? She was like, oh no, it's all right. We'll get one next time. Like, I don't know if I've mentioned this already, but I don't have a lot of faith in my midwife. She's had 3 major boo-boos, and I've only seen her once. So the first one was, she didn't take a pee sample off me the first time I went. Like, I don't know if she forgot or whatever. So she had to text me and say, oh, is it okay if you nip back in with a pee sample for me? Yeah, all right, fine. And then her second boo-boo was, I went to the hospital to have the 12-week scan and all the blood tests and everything done. And the girl, the, you know, nurses there, they took my bloods and they went, sorry, can I just ask, who's your midwife? It's Tracy. She went, oh, is it? Midwife's Tracy, to the other nurse that was there. And I was like, what? And she was like, oh, nothing. I was like, no, come on, tell me. She said, all right. She's not filled in. Oh, no, sorry. She hasn't filled in this form with all your details, which means, whoa. Which means if I'd sent this off and without checking whether your details were on it, they would have rejected it. I said, oh, right. She said, so what she should have done is put a sheet of stickers in with your name and address on so that you can just go slap, bang, done, you know. But she hadn't done that. So I was like, oh, right. Fair enough. Then when I went for my flu jab, which I'm never having again, the nurse said to me, oh, are you all fit and well, ready for your flu jab? And I said, yeah, apart from being pregnant. And she went, oh, you're pregnant? Yeah. Oh. It doesn't say on your medical record you're pregnant. I was like, right. Yeah, that's pretty bad, Tracy. You need to get your shit together, love. Anyway, she said to me today that at my next appointment, which will be beginning of February, she said it might not be me because I might be at the hospital. So would you like to come with me? Would you like to stay, remain under my care and come and have your appointments at Huddersfield? I was like, are you thinking about having the baby at Huddersfield? I was like, she said, well, shall I put you on my list of a maybe? I was like, yeah, maybe. So yeah, it looks like I'm getting rid of her without even having to try, which is excellent. Dan and Rosy have been teasing me all day about how fat I am. Bastards. I say fat, pregnant, how pregnant I am. I shouldn't say fat. Because yeah, I really feel like I've popped this week. I keep saying that every week, but this week it's like, whoa. Like this t-shirt I have on today was baggy the last time I wore it. And now it's like, oh, there's an avocado inside you, pushing it out. I'm feeling very fat and ugly because I'm so spotty and ill. Obviously, that doesn't help. Yeah. And because it's a solo gig tonight with the band, like Louise is busy again. I really should wear something nice, you know, like fronting the band, leading lady, nice, you know. But I can't be arsed. I'm literally going to wear black leggings and a black t-shirt. I just don't care anymore. I know things get better. I know it gets easier. That's fine. I'm not complaining about that, but I feel as if I've been chatting for way too long. It's going to be way too much for me to edit, and I won't do it. So I better go, hadn't I? I will put a little clip in to finish off this vlog of the band doing a little something, possibly a Christmas song, seeing as it's a Vlogmas. And yeah, I'll end the vlog here. I'll see you tomorrow for Vlogmas Day 7. Yay! Oh no, wait, this is Vlogmas Day 7. Hi! Vlogmas Day 8 tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!
So hard, I'm punching my car. 8 hours for what? Well, tell me what I got. I got this feeling when times are holding me down. You're playing so cool, obeying every rule. Keep way down in your heart.
Beautifully. I didn't get any footage of us singing because my camera fell over.